Hello and welcome back. Today we're at the Gregg Museum of Design and Art at NC State University, located in Raleigh, North Carolina. Here is a whirligig sculpture. This is a gentleman that lives in North Carolina. Actually, he passed away a few years ago, but he would take scraps from road signs, airplanes, whatever metal he could find, to create whirligigs. And there's a whole bunch of them in this one town in North Carolina. I'll look it up and put it on the screen for you. I can't remember what city it is, but it's really cool to go see that. I'll try to go see that and put it up on here for you guys one day. So we're gonna head on into the museum here. It says there's a pollinator garden around the perimeter out here. So you have a very classic looking building next to this very modern building. It's really pretty. And then right here is one of the campus buildings. Really old. It looks like it's probably early 1900s. So this museum is free and it's open, I believe it was Tuesday through Saturday. Some rain chains hanging down from the porch here. All right, we're gonna start with selections from the collection. And here's a pamphlet about the whirligigs. So if you get a chance, you should go check that out as well. Wow, that's a beautiful quilt. This one's called Prisoner in the Land of Liberty. Death lives in the desert. Oh, this one's interesting. It's a bunch of Harley Davidson and NASCAR fabrics that have created this piece. This one's called I Am the Night Rider. Changing perspectives. Add a comma. Different old cameras. I actually have one very similar to this one that I got for free. I've never taken a picture with it though. Oh wow, this one's amazing. These are words cut out. And it's layered in front of another one. Hold on, let me try to focus. There it goes. Oh, that's cool. Got some photography. That's an interesting way to use a little dolly. Oh my, got some nice light fixtures in here. So this must be the older wing of the building. nice, lovely garden. So after we tour the inside, we're going to have to pop out there and see what's outside.
Oh, look at these phones. These are great. For all you young folks, this is what we used to make phone calls on. These purses, I'm a lover of purses. Even though I hate carrying them, I do love a very cool artistic purse like this. Like, those are neat. Look at all that beadwork. Really pretty building. That looks like a basketball. Folk art. I love some folk art because it's not so formal, it's fun, representative of the community. That's a cool guitar. And we have these Ubuntu mask from the 20th century. I'm sorry if I pronounced that wrong. From Sierra Leone. It's a beautiful basket made from yucca leaves. Pretty fireplace. These are Native American arts from New Mexico, Arizona. Oh, this is cute. Beautiful art. Day turtles, earthenware, mineral oxides, and metallic acrylic. You see the words in there? These are from Indonesia. There's a puppet from Indonesia. He's a little scary looking. Some more puppets. They have a rich history of puppeteering there, as you can see. The faces are great. This is from Hawaii. Ooh, I Oscar de la Renta, 1963. Oops, there's a bench there. Oh, that's lovely. And then the pink dress is Joffrey Beam. It looks silk. Let's see. Oh, it is silk. That one's from 1977. I love me some vintage fashion, so. Another lovely fireplace with some gorgeous pieces above it. Wow, look at the glaze on that. It kind of looks like they cut away at it. I haven't seen a glaze like that before. Wow, this is interesting. It looks like a chapel, but it's made from gun parts and bullets. Oh my goodness. Look at that. Can you see it from up there? No. I probably could look down on it if I could get the camera in there, but I don't think I can. Wow. That's interesting. Very unexpected. Here's a carved platter. Nice Celtic-like knots. I love how it glows right here. Look at all the shoes. These look terribly uncomfortable, but easy to repair. Japanese prints. Sat next is absolutely gorgeous. Come on now. Those metallic threads just glisten against the silk. Beautiful detail. All these cranes. Here's the back of it. And then sat next to that is this one. That is interesting. So they use packaging from lots of different fast food restaurants like Wendy's and McDonald's to create this kimono. Okay, we're going to head into the other side of the gallery now.
little pieces cut out and pasted to the still life in the background. This one's really big. I'm gonna have to back up. Looks like a quilt of lots of different photos with what looks like planets imposed on top. Interesting collage. Another one, very similar concept. The little red lines remind me of when people were trying to figure out a mystery. Interesting to look at the thought process of an artist. We'll look down into the boxes on the pass back. This looks like cigar boxes. Find out in a moment when we get to the end. Cigar box encyclopedia. Okay, one letter of the alphabet. Okay, interesting. And if they're in alphabetical order. It's got a bird and a beetle. Oh, okay. Ammo, arm, atomic bomb. Okay, okay. Had to think about it there. Cord, coin, cat claw, maybe? CD. Interesting chain, dominoes, donkey, dodo bird. These are interesting. Here's E. F. G. H. I. What's he holding? I
I guess jawbone. K. Kiwi pies. And a cat. Kids. Yeah. Well, there's where the Barbie legs ended up. Yeah. I don't like it. It's a maze. I wish you could pick it up. That'd be cool. And play with the little ball. Go around the maze. Yeah. Nude, I guess. And lots of nails. Nails on nails. P. Q. I guess quarter horse, maybe quarterback on a quarter horse. R. Ooh, look at that rat. S. Old Tommy TV. You. Sea urchins. No sea urchin spines. V. Venus. W. X-ray. Y, this is the smallest one, and Z. Awesome, those are interesting. Look at the slides, these are old. They've poked holes in it, so all these little tiny dots you see is actually light coming through it. All right, let's look at this big collage here. This one is Shakespeare in the Park. Memories from summers in New York City, Central Park. If you like a greater view of this, you can always slow the video down. I just don't want to make it terribly long. Beauty without the grace is the hook without the bait. Yes, queen. Evolution of a species. Indication of an idea. There's a lot of cicadas in there.
nice cute little claw feet on that. Oh my goodness. Twenty-two eyeballs and one asshole. That just like automatically made me think of Pokemon. They look like eggs though. Let's see. Oh, they are. Well, it says this is not an egg. Casablanca, Colorado. And the next one over, Casablanca Classic. Let me see if I can back up so you can see both together. So it's like the negative of it, the opposite. That's cool. I like how they have the little dots coming down, kind of like it's drippy. It was like it was poured from the heavens. This could be a chair. Could this be a chair? Like a study on the Matisse. Another huge collage. Like this thing's probably 8 feet tall, about 10 feet wide. This is a really large collage in two parts, as you can see there. What's love got to do with it? Oh no, that just made that song pop into my head. Here's some watermelon and different sceneries. I always think it's interesting to see collections of the same item done multiple ways, see the process that they went through. Colorful and geometric. Celebration blue and celebration orange and blue stripes. Oh, doesn't that just make you want to go have a picnic on the beach? That would be lovely. Motorcycles. Needlepoint of a zebra pattern. It's Still life with bottles in green and brown. I love the monochrome factor and how simple the shapes are. But you can still tell what it is without it being too abstract. Here's some information about this artist in the show here. So this is a South Carolina artist that's featured here today. This is not a guy. Tonic. So it appears that she went to incorporate found objects into her pieces quite often, which in this day and age is a very good thing, better than sending it to the landfill. Very drawn to this because I've always loved anatomy books, and it was actually my son's favorite book of all was Human Anatomy. Like, he would look through that book for hours when he was a kid. Well, he's still a kid, but when he was really little, like a toddler, probably until he's about 6 years old. They have a spyglass here. I'm not sure how you're supposed to use it because it's stuck in there. There's no way to get it out. And it can't go up the hole. missed this piece earlier. It's got the North Carolina emblem on it, and it looks like really good stuff. Let's see. Whoops. My bad. I was trying to zoom in on it. Okay, now that we've finished looking at the gallery inside, we're going to take a gander at the pollinator garden outside. This is located on the side and back of the gallery, and it's also free. So, in case you missed it, there's the whirligig by Mr. Simpson. School and Art Center. Here's a little sound conservatory that you can see inside the museum. Lots of nice seating areas over here. Little dry creek bed. Got some lovely flowers, and the path just meanders down and around. Ugh, my shoes are squeaking. I'm so sorry if y'all can hear that. This is my first time wearing these shoes, and I had no idea that they squeaked. Like, that's super annoying. Looks like they got some flowers up on the hill too at the Art Center. Some cannas over here blooming. Oh, this is lovely. Too bad it's not on. The little fish sprays out water. And it doesn't look like there's any fish in the pond either, like live fish. Hydrangea with a bumblebee on it. Lovely marble sculptures over there. Got some butterfly bushes, black-eyed Susans, just all sorts of nice pollinating plants. Wonder if anything's back here. Probably not, but we'll take a peek. Just the dry creek bed. And they're constructing something over there. We'll get a closer view of the marble sculptures and then we'll wrap up this tour. So I hope you enjoyed this. This is my first time visiting this art museum. It's very quaint. And it was very close to the Dorothy Dix Park. Like, I think it took me about 7 minutes to get here, and that's because of traffic. So, oh, and there's Pullen Park right down the road from here, which is fantastic. I love Pullen Park. If you watch my previous video of the lights, luminosity, that was Pullen Park. They have a lot of kiddie rides there, like carousel, nice park, a little lake you can walk around, a food vendor. So, you should go check that out if you're over here. Lots of things to do for free or super cheap, clustered right here in Raleigh. Well, if you enjoyed this, please come back. There's going to be plenty more videos like this. So subscribe to my channel and see what else is to come. I appreciate you as always, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.